Here begins the book of the birth of the Blessed Mary and the childhood of our Savior, which was written in Hebrew by the most reverend apostle Matthew. The holy and majestic Virgin Mary was born in the city of Nazareth, descended from David's royal bloodline, and received her instruction in the Lord's temple in Jerusalem. Her father's name was Joachim, and his family was from Galilee and the city of Nazareth. Her mother's name was Anna, and her family was from Bethlehem. They lived plainly and honestly before God, piously and blamelessly in the sight of men. According to the chronicles of the 12 tribes of Israel, Joachim, a wealthy man of Judah's line, was in Jerusalem at this time. He shepherded his own sheep and loved the Lord wholeheartedly and with all integrity. His entire concern was for the well-being of his herds, and from the food that they produced, he fed every God-fearing person, honoring God by offering a twofold charity to everyone who served him and who worked at teaching. He brought all of his offerings before the Lord, saying, "What I bring as a sacrifice for my own sins will be dedicated to the Lord, that he might be appeased with me. What is over and above that will be for the people to use." So his entire income, his lambs, his sheep, his wool, and everything else that he owned was split three ways. One part was devoted to orphans, widows, foreigners, and the needy. Another to the temple, its officials, and those who worship God. And the third part he reserved for his own needs and those of his entire family. He practiced this level of generosity from the age of 15 years, and all the while God compounded his flocks and his wealth, such that there was no one else like him in all of Israel. When he was 20, he married Anna, the daughter of Issachar, who shared his lineage from David. They practiced this decent way of living for about 20 years, being approved by God and respected by men. Yet she bore him neither sons nor daughters. The great day of the Lord was approaching, and the people of Israel were bringing their oblations. Now during the festal days, Joseph was gathering his gifts before the Lord in the company of some other people who were offering their incense up. And this priest named Reuben rose to his feet, walked over to Joachim and said, "It is unlawful for you to stand here alongside these others and present your offerings ahead of those who are sacrificing to God, seeing that you have fathered no children in Israel." But they had solemnly pledged that if God should bless them with a child, they would consecrate it to the service of the Lord, which was why they went to the Lord's temple during every feast of the year.